This is our channel, Healthy Kidney Inc., where we empower you with great information to help your kidney health. If you're new to our channel, subscribe and check out over 200 videos that we have here. And today, we're talking about hot sauce, that condiment, and if you can fit it into a kidney diet. Now, when you think about hot sauce, a lot of times you may think you can't fit it in because of the sodium. It is loaded with salt, but not all of them on the market out there. So we're gonna go over a few brands. And with hot sauce, you can make your own. So the base of hot sauce recipes are gonna be vinegar, chili peppers, and generally salt. And you can add in a lot of different spices, from garlic powders to different seasonings to even sugar, a lot of the commercial brands have. So if you make your own, that's always the best way, but it's not always feasible and an option for everybody. So if you're gonna go out there and purchase hot sauce, I got a couple brands here I wanna discuss. First off, always look at the back of the labels, because I couldn't cover every possible hot sauce out there. And so depending on your area, what you have available, you may find some really good options, but always look at the back of the label, because that's where it's going to tell you where all the sodium is. So here's a couple brands that I have here. So the number one winner always of all time for commercially prepared hot sauces is Tabasco. It's got 35 to 40 milligrams per teaspoon. So we're always looking at teaspoon servings. You might not think a teaspoon is a lot, but it is quite a bit when it comes to hot sauce. We want to try to stick to a teaspoon. If you have any more, make sure you account for the sodium. But what I'm talking about here is using one teaspoon. So Tabasco, it's always a top winner, lowest in sodium. Another one is Cholula. At about 100 to 110 grams of milligram, 110 milligrams of sodium, it's 100 to 110. And always look at yours, because they're gonna vary a little bit per batch of the manufacturing. So they may manufacture one batch and it's 90 milligrams, and the next one's 100, but they're not gonna vary that much. So Cholula, that's another hot sauce. El Yucateco, okay, El Yucateco, they have a green and a red chili habanero that comes in at about 90 to 100 milligrams. Per teaspoon of sodium. Frank's Red Hot. Oh, I like Frank's Red Hot, but unfortunately it's high sodium. Sorry guys, it's 190 to 200 or more milligrams of sodium. So scratch that one off the list. I wanted to mention it because it's a very popular one that a lot of people ask me about. Sambal Olek, about 85 milligrams of sodium per teaspoon. I haven't seen this one myself. Sriracha, so I've used this one before. That's in the 80 to 100 milligram area. Tapatio, okay, another commercial brand, and it comes in that 100 to 110 milligrams of sodium. Valentina, another one that comes in very low at like 65 to 75 milligrams of sodium, but I have never actually seen that one. Only seen it online, not in person. I haven't purchased it. So there's a list that you can use, list you can go through. If you want to get that list exactly, this video will be on our website, also in the description below. But feel free to enjoy some hot sauces and the different hot sauce varieties that you can make on your own. And always try making your own. That's the best thing, because you can include no sodium. Thanks for watching, everybody. Check out our other videos. Bye.